Hi, my name is Hannes Beem, and in this tutorial I'd like to show you how you can denoise an image using NVIDIA AI Denoiser. And the denoiser is inside of the NVIDIA Optics program, and it's not a program you can open through the start menu, but we can utilize it by a program that's written by Declan or Declan Russell. I'm not a native English speaker, so I don't know how to properly pronounce his name. I got this tip from Al Markov, and Al Markov is a member of the Mandelbulb Maniacs group on Facebook. And let's dive right in. We need to go to this website. It's the github.com, and you have to enter Declan Russell's name and then say NVIDIA AI denoiser. And when we are here, there's a couple of things you need. Of course, you need an NVIDIA graphics card. It won't work on an AMD card. And we need the NVIDIA Optics program, which you can download via this link. This will lead to the NVIDIA website. The graphics card that's needed will be GTX 1000 or higher, I believe. And of course, you need a recent video driver. Let's say this says it requires the NVIDIA R495.89 driver for this version, for the SDK 7.4. And I'm only going to cover the Windows 10 version for this video. And let's click on it to download. And it will ask if you want to log in or join. And if you don't have an NVIDIA Developer Program membership, you should choose Join Now. And it will ask you to enter your email address. And via your email, you will get a link to sign up for the program. And then you can download the program itself. And when you download the program itself, it'll show up as a file. It'll look like this, and you can just install this file. Now you won't get a program you can access through your start menu, because this program is mainly used inside of other 3D, inside of 3D applications, maybe like Blender or 3ds Max or something. Maya, what else is there? Cinema 4D, etc. But Declan Russell, or Declan Russell, created a program so that we can access the denoise function through a command line. So when we have NVIDIA Optics installed, we can install the program from Declan Russell's website. So let's go visit the website via this link. And here you can see an example that is made with an image that has quite a lot of noise. It's really heavy noise, and it's pretty decent. The result is pretty decent, and I think our image will look even better. And then a bit below, we have the program itself, and you can just download this. And when it is downloaded, we open it inside the downloads folder. Maybe it'll download to another folder on your system, I don't know. Just try to find it. It's called denoiser_v2.4. And we have to unzip this, so I'll do a right click, and then you can choose the zip program you have. It depends on what you have. Let's see, I have WinRAR and 7-zip, and I'll choose 7-zip. You could also use the version, the unzipper from Windows itself if you have it. And then let's extract to a folder. And I'm going to open this folder, and you can see this is the program, and this is the executable file denoiser.exe. Now I'm going to rename this folder, and you can do this two ways. You can just right click and click rename, or you can click, wait a second, and click again. And the interruption of a second is important, because if you just double click really quick, it'll open up the folder again. And we need to remove this part, so like this. And I want to make it easy for myself, and I'll cut this folder. And you can also click on it and hold control and then press the X together with the control button to cut it. And now I want to have it on my C drive, where my Windows is also located, and I'll just right click and paste it here, or press control on the keyboard and press the V of from Victor. If you press them together, it'll paste the folder right here. So let's see, now we have this folder here, and we have this file name denoiser.exe, and now we should be able to access the program with the command line. So I'm going to the search bar, and it's already here, and you can right click it and choose run as administrator. But if it isn't showing up here, you can search for it with the CMD, and then the command prompt will appear. I don't know if it's necessary, but usually I run this thing as an administrator, so I won't encounter any issues with the Windows refusing my command line or anything. Now we need to scroll down to the comments section and look for this message, and it says that to use the command line, you enter in the drive where it's located with the folder, and then the file name, and then minus I, and then the folder where you want where the file is located, the image, it can be a JPEG, it can be a PNG file. Then you enter in minus O, and then the location where you want to save the file and the file name. Let's see, this is named noisy image, and he names it denoised image. And you can give it the same file name, but then you will overwrite the original one. So that's something to keep in mind. I have my file ready on my F drive in the denoise folder, and it's called denoise. And when I go to properties with the right click, it'll say PNG file. So that's something I have to take into account. Let's do this. Let's first go to the C drive and then enter in the folder name. The folder name was denoiser, and the file name was denoiser.exe. Then the minus I, then the C drive. Oh no, sorry, this is the F drive, and then the folder is called denoise, and the file is called denoise, and it's a PNG file. Now to save it inside the denoise folder, and I'll name it denoised with a D, and then .png. So now I'm going to press enter. And it says there's no output file extension. That means I made a mistake. I pressed the function tree key to get this all back. And as you can see, I missed the minus O. So let's enter that in. Now press enter. Alright, that loaded successfully. The image is created, it's denoised, and it took a fraction of a second, and it's saved to denoised.png. It says it's done, so that's perfect. Let's open up the folder and the file, and let's see. This is the noise, the image with the noise. You see there's quite a lot of noise. And this is the denoised image, which looks really good in my opinion, and I think Nvidia did a fantastic job with this denoiser. So that's it for now, and I'll see you in another tutorial.